When I was in high school, I was on a few very good basketball teams. So shout out to Coach Lancaster, Coach Powell, and Coach Zessen. Now, the basketball teams that I were a part of had a specific makeup, right? It was anchored by my big brother, O, in the middle. We had Avery Hill or Chuck as our point guard. The original CP3, Clay Pittman, was our shooting guard. And then we had Chris Staley, the Black Swan. But then the fifth guy was me, right? And I was just there. So I had to figure out what was my position, what was my role on the basketball team. And I remember a few very specific conversations with Connie Powell. And what he said to me was, Neal, figure out how you're going. Well, he said, Junior. He said, Junior, figure out how you're going to get on the court and how you're going to stay on the court. What's going to be your role? What's going to be your position? And I found out what everyone else was doing. I saw what their strengths were, and I saw where we were lacking as a team and where I could contribute. And that was in crashing the boards or rebounding. Now, I've taken lessons from basketball and I've applied them to my life, and I want to share those with you really quickly just about rebounding. See, in basketball, there's only, and there probably will always only be one ball on the court at a time. And on each team, there's going to be five people. So there'll never be enough balls on the court for people to shoot as much as they want. So one of my roles and what I began to love is that every time I rebounded, my team had another opportunity. My team had another chance. We got another, round to get something right that did not go right the first time. Now, what I loved was when I would get a rebound and I would pass it back out to Avery or to CP Clay, they would say a word, reset, reset, reset. Right now, so I want to ask you, what have you rebounded from, or what have you had to rebound from that benefits others, right? That allows them to reset. Have you had to rebound from tough relationships in, or tough conversations that you've had with a sibling or a family member or friend? Have you had to rebound from a tough relationship with a parent or a child? Right? Have you had to rebound after a financial loss? Have you had to rebound and make best of a bad situation when it comes to, I guess, a work situation? Like for me, I know I've had to rebound numerous times in my life from health issues. I've had to rebound from divorce. I've had to rebound from friendships that have fallen apart. And what I find is that when I effectively rebound, when I crash the boards, when I see an area that things didn't go right, and instead of me saying, okay, well, there's nothing I can do about it, when I go back and I come again and I take another chance and I get a chance to reset that area of my life. So I just want to ask you, what is it that you have had to rebound in for others? But also, what have you had to rebound? What areas do you need to rebound in your life? Now, I've mentioned many times that every time I'm talking to you, I'm actually speaking to myself and you're just listening in. So every day I'm finding ways that I have to rebound, that I have to try to redo or fix or recoup something that didn't go as planned. Now, for me, it could be a relationship. It could be a conversation. It could be a bad decision, or maybe a good decision at the time, or what I thought was a good decision that didn't go as planned. And that could be personally or professionally. What I found was in when I was in high school, and when I would get a rebound, my teammates, they tended to forget that they missed the shot, right? And here's how I know, because when I would throw it back out, they would shoot it again. And I would say, hold on, wait, pass it in to me. At least let me get a chance, right? But then I would get another rebound and I would pass it out. And guess what happens? they would shoot it again. So many times you being a rebounder or you crashing the boards or you helping others or even helping yourself get another chance to do things right is going to require you to lose your ego. It's going to require you not to care who gets the credit, not to care the outcome or who's the MVP as long as you are part of the winning team, right? So something that I've heard very, very frequently is that people forget, yes, Michael Jordan has 6 rings, but guess what? So does Robert Horry, right? He won with the Houston Rockets. He won with the Chicago Bulls. People forget that Scottie Pippen has the rings. People forget because instead of them taking a place and being the rebounder, 2 of my favorite basketball players of all times were Ben Wallace and Dennis Rodman, and they were not prolific scorers, but they knew their role and they were rebounders. And here's how I took what I learned in high school into adulthood in actually the basketball area of my life. So just think about this as you go through today. To courts for pickup games, I would just say, if I could just play one game and preferably the first game, if I just came to a court and if I played one game, I knew that I would get chosen to play every other game. Here's why. Because when you're playing park ball, everyone out there wants to shoot the ball. I would go out with the intention of if I rebound and if I just pass it out and if I hustle, I know that every shooter on the court is going to want me on their team. So many times I would go out to the court, I would get to play in the first game, second game maybe, get a lot of rebounds, pass it out. And when it came time to choose the team after, even if I was on the losing team, I know that the team after me was going to have a place for me on their roster. Now, real quick, something else I learned about rebounding while I was playing basketball was that not only will others forget that they missed shots, but people will begin to see how valuable you are to their success. Right, I know many times Clay Pittman, Avery, Chris, and they would look at me when the fans or the crowd, when they did not see the value that I brought, I knew that my team and my coaches, they understood. They would come to me and say, Junior, great job. So understanding that when you help others get to where they need to be by rebounding for them or even rebounding in your own life, understand that there is a value that's added to them that at times many people on the outside will never see and that you will never get the credit for. So that's going to do it for this time of Neal at Noon. Until next time, God loves you, I love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. And don't be average, be world renowned. Peace.